Welcome back to The Week in AI. I'm Kevin Cook, your field guide and storyteller for the fascinating arena of artificial intelligence. We did another space last Friday, July 11th, with my co-host, Ethan Feller. This is his handle on X. And I'm going to run through some of the highlights. We talked about a lot of cool stuff. As always, we each have six topics and we try and run through them rapid fire at 5 minutes apiece and see if we can get it done in an hour. I think we went a little over. We had some audio problems, but still worth listening to. And even if you don't listen to the replay, which you can find here, and I will link to in various places, what I'm about to show you in the comments is basically a curated archive of all the highlights for the week in AI. So from all the experts outside of X, you know, academic papers, and then AI experts that are all over X that I always recommend to follow. So that's what you always get with the Week in AI is a curated menu. And just going through that, you will definitely find some good stuff to put on your plate. By the way, if you're watching on YouTube, go down in the description and you can find a link to an article version of this. And the article version is basically a summary where I flesh out some things some more. And it'll have links. It'll link back to this space on X. And so you could also find me at Kevin B. Cook. All right, let's dive in. So I titled this, The Week in AI, $9,000 Humanoid Robots, Zuck the Poacher, Larry Page Skynet, because he's got something cool going on that Ethan talked about. All right, let's dive in. So first up, $9,000 Humanoid Robots, K-Scale Labs. What? This is so cool. These guys, these 20-something nerdgeneers in Palo Alto are living in this nice house together and just building. And this guy, the lead guy here, Benjamin Bolt, he worked at Tesla and Meta, I think. So he's got a pedigree, but he says the team he surrounded himself with of these young engineers, he couldn't be happier in what they're building. But that the big thing is here, not only is it affordable at $9,000, it's open source. So, and he said, if you watch this video, he said, you know, he wanted to beat Tesla Optimus and Figure to the market with an open source affordable product. And so they're having some fun there, but they did it. And man, these guys are my heroes. All right, moving on here. This is General Matter is a uranium company. This CEO, Scott Nolan, this is a pretty intense quote about where we're headed. He says, AI demand could match the entire U.S. power grid by 2030. Without urgent expansion of nuclear reactors and fuel, we don't just risk brownouts and skyrocketing energy costs. We risk not getting AI at all. Obviously, he's talking his book, since he sells uranium and related industrial infrastructure. But we've heard it from Eric Schmidt. And so, like, since I heard from Eric Schmidt first that we're about 95 nuclear reactors short for what we need in the next 5 years, I believe this guy too. All right, here's another link from one of the engineers from K-Scale Robotics, Jing Ziang, I think is how you say his name. And his perspective is, right now, robotics is a mess because it's, you know, it's not open source, it's not affordable, and it's not, you know, it's not effective and efficient. So that's what they're trying to achieve. All right, moving on here. Is this for PD? Yeah. So Prisoner's Dilemma. So very complex game. Actually, it doesn't seem that complex, but to teach a large language model to play it well, and then actually what this study did is it found out what type of LLM are you. So, you know, are you one that goes for the kill in Prisoner's Dilemma? You know, and they just created and where they could just iterate and have the different LLMs go through millions of iterations. So that's worth looking at. Rohan Paul is a great follow. What's he talking about here? Don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. Oh, the ARC AGI test, sort of a standard. It's not like the humanities last exam, but it's similar in testing the intelligence. So deep learning alone now cracks 58% of the hidden ARC test after adding on-the-fly tuning. That's worth taking a look at. Dari Unutmaz is a physician, and he just wrote a paper at Stanford using something called, or he used something from Stanford called CoStorm AI to help write a review on an immune cancer topic, and he was extremely impressed with what the model could do. All right, so one of my themes was Zuck the poacher. Well, because he's just buying, bribing, and stealing talent anywhere he can. You know, we saw the acquihire of Scale AI, $14.3 billion for 49 cents, 49% of the company. So you get Alexander Wang. Alexander Wang comes on board with like, a dozen recruits. And, you know, so I think Zuck has got it down right. And I did an interview with Apple, not with Apple, about Apple. I did an interview with Bloomberg last Friday, and they published the article on Monday, where I said Apple needs to adopt the Zuckerberg strategy of being super aggressive with talent, because the war for talent can make or break things right now. If you hire top people and let them run, let them cook, that's what Tim Cook needs to do at Apple. And so he could learn a thing or two from Zuck. But speaking of the talent wars, this just popped up. It wasn't even in our space last week. So I just published this article this morning. This is Wednesday morning, July 16th. You're probably seeing this article on the 17th. Google goes windsurfing in the AI war for talent. So Google does their own acquihire. Remember that OpenAI was going to buy Windsurf, an AI coding development platform, for like $3 billion. Well, that deal fell apart because Microsoft had conflicts. Google swoops in and grabs Windsurf, and they get talent and then another small company. So I'll just go to this article. Well, I said the acquihire strategy is on fire in this battle among tech titans seeking dominance, and a Goliath just beat David. The Goliath is Google beating the David, OpenAI. So check out this article. You can find it search Google up here in the upper right corner. You should come across this article. What else did I want to show you in here? Oh, and I also linked to my interview with Bloomberg about how Apple needs to step up. Now, they don't need to go buy. They don't need to spend $10 to $100 billion on another company, which they won't do anyway. They just need to go on a talent acquisition spree and let the people cook, so to speak. So, all right, back to the week in AI. Because, well, the Google thing, we'll probably talk about this Friday again. All right, let me keep going through here. Oh, this is great. Coatue is a big investment management firm on Wall Street, but also in Silicon Valley in a lot of private startups. They have quite a portfolio of startups that they backed. Well, they put together this deck, The Great Separation. They call it Who Wins and Who Gets Left Behind in the AI Age. Jason Lemkin did a great job pulling out 10 slides, you know, data-rich slides with Coatue's observations. Coatue, run by a man named Lafont, it's French. Anyway, if you watch the replay in the week and a half, I go through these 10 slides and I pick out what I thought was the coolest stuff. Here's Casper making fun of Microsoft. Speaking of acquiring talent, here's how Microsoft screwed it up. They're almost like the Yahoo of old, where they buy a startup and then they do nothing with it, and the team fizzles. Microsoft acquires WizardLM. They do absolutely nothing and riddle them with politics. WizardLM leaves for Tencent in May and comes up with a state-of-the-art reasoning model in June. Go figure. Hugging Face CEO Clem DeLange talking about, you know, building and running robotics locally, on-prem, on the edge. Inference on the edge, just like, you know, Jensen is trying to give us with DGX Spark. $3,000, you put it on your desktop and you got a billion parameter instrument that you can develop on. All right, this is cool. This is one of my cool topics, medical superintelligence. So come and look at this. I highly recommend that you listen to the space too, because I go over about four different innovations in medicine that some of these LLMs are giving us. And so this Microsoft model is very exciting. Here's, you know, Khosla saying AI robotics will have their ChatGPT moment in the next 2 to 3 years. I don't disagree there. It's the same thing Clem DeLange's talking about. All right. The Mark, the P Mark, Mark Andreessen, he's got his hands in everything, right? He's an investor in Tesla, SpaceX, XAI, probably Optimus too, I'm sure. And he's worried about our industrial development. And so that's a theme I talk about, is the building the super industrial parks, right? We just had SoftBank's Masayoshi Son say he wants to build a $1 trillion mega hub in Arizona, along with Taiwan Semiconductor, on the model of Shenzhen in China, which they do well. Concentrate all the key players, the architects of technology, AI, robotics, whatever, and have them close to each other, so there's less friction for using each other's services and technology and also talent transfer. All right, Gary Marcus always got him in there. Yeah, Andrew Yang says AGI is overhyped. Humans will stay relevant. Yes, but it's coming. Something's coming. AGI will be powerful in some ways that we can't predict. Imad says, yeah, AGI won't be a god mind. You just want it to be like your coworker. All right, this shows how fast things are moving, accelerating. If we stay on this exponential, most human tasks will be replicatable, if I may coin that word, in the next, basically 80% of human tasks will be done by agents in the next 5 years because of the time constraints. Okay, this is cool from Dr. Singularity. An autonomous scientific engine has arrived. This is very cool. This is what, a scientist who is AI native, so to speak, wants an assistant like this that can come up with a hypothesis and then run and test it and build knowledge, or at least data, then maybe knowledge, then insights, then a theory. So that's super cool. All right, here's the Alexander Wang team from Scale AI joining Zuck at Meta. Let's see if I had anything else good in here. Oh, as far as Manhattan projects, yeah, I just want to show you that. Let's see here. I got a lot of stuff about jobs in this one, as always. Amanda Good, she's at the job check. She says, IBM laid off 8,000 HR employees, not for budget, not for performance, but basically because they could. They wanted to test. Can we replace HR, all these functions in HR? How many can be automated? And a lot, they found, could be automated. So this becomes a model for other corporations. IBM could basically go sell it. And it's similar to what I talked about a few weeks ago with those mercenaries at Mechanize who want to, do the same thing for corporate America. All right, this is cool what Ethan Feller brought up. How big could an AI Manhattan project get? So Ethan found this. Let's see, I think this is it. So this is a good piece from Epic AI. We've got the links in there. Talking about the idea of, so apparently a U.S.-China Economic and Security Review Commission listed that its top recommendation to Congress was to establish and fund a Manhattan Project-like program dedicated to racing to and acquiring an AGI capability. Oh, makes sense, right? Let me see if I can find Mr. Masayoshi Son and his, because once you see the picture, oh, here's Jensen. We're going to talk about him. Big news this week already, so this will be on Friday's show. Lifting export restrictions. Jensen can sell GPUs to China. And here he is in China, his third trip to China this year, talking about robotics. So that'll be in this Friday's show for sure. Here's a cool robotics guy. All right, where's my... Oh, here's bad news for Zuck. This is going to be on this Friday's show because this is very recent, from July 14th. They're having a little problem with their behemoth model. And they're going to bring it, they're going to move it from open source to closed source. So trouble in Zuckland there. All right, let me see where I can find this. Maybe I put it, because I just did a thing on Taiwan Semiconductor yesterday. I did the video for Taiwan Semiconductor and I put it there. Okay, yeah, so here we go. So you can find this in my feed, talking about Taiwan Semiconductor. And so Masayoshi Son, CEO of SoftBank, has a plan for something called Project Crystal Land, a $1 trillion complex in Arizona focused on AI and robotics. He wants to model the Shenzhen mega hub. And here he is. So that's the man with the money and the ideas. And, he's partnered with Sam Altman from OpenAI, Larry Ellison from Oracle to build Stargate down in Texas, where they're going to build at least 10 data centers down there. And then who knows what comes after that. I would think they would build a mega tech industrial park down in Texas, in addition to the one that I talked about in Northern California. All right. I think I've covered a lot. Definitely want you to come and check out our live spaces when we do them on Fridays. Here, Ethan Feller's got some more good stuff in here. What else did I want to show you that he had? Oh, he talked about Larry Page. Larry Page's new startup is called Dynatomics, focused on using AI to revolutionize product manufacturing. So this is pretty, you know, this is like industrial automation, right? Not just robotics, but, you know, let's automate manufacturing overall. That sounds huge. That sounds like it would fit in with some of these Manhattan projects that I'm talking about. Let's see what else Ethan found here. Ethan's links go at the bottom because since I created the space, it's like my links come first, but Ethan always brings awesome stuff that I didn't even see coming. So definitely you want to, let me scroll back to the top so you can see what our space looks like. I have not made the name and the date for this Friday space, but just come and find me at Kevin B. Cook and you'll see a new one. It'll probably be dated today, July 16th, for the broadcast live. You can come with us live at 1 p.m. Eastern on July 18th. But here's the replay for the one we just went over. And again, even if you don't listen to the replay, just find this and you get to go through all these links yourself and play the recordings, especially this K-Scale one. It's so inspiring to see these young guys put this together. What else? Okay, again, if you're watching on YouTube, go down in the description. You'll find a link to the article version, which has all the links. It'll link back to X and the space. And then you know where to find me on X at Kevin B. Cook. So we will see. If we don't see you Friday, find us on the replays. All right, talk to you soon.